So you might be wondering, like, what's the cost to do all this stuff? You know, this probably ran me close to $10,000 to do this. And you might be thinking that's insane, but maybe you are in a market where you need to spend $10,000 in order to really attract top clients. But here's the bonus, guys. Yes, I spent $10,000 on designing it and getting all the stuff in here. I got a really amazing refinance value and was able to get it all back. So it was relatively, everything you're seeing is relatively for free. What's up, guys? It's Jeff Weibel here, and we are in London, Ontario, and we're in my Airbnb right now. And this wasn't always an Airbnb. I actually lived in this unit, and I really want you guys to think, if you have any owner-occupied units or any vacancies that are popping up ever in your portfolio, or you want to purchase a home like this, this is the kind of stuff you can do. And this is how I was able to design this with a designer to attract top-end clients coming to town, which is not only on Airbnb, but also executive renters that are coming. Airbnb is almost my secondary here, and I'm able to attract top people that are coming to town, doctors and other business people that need a place to stay. They don't wanna be at the Hilton all week. It's the same thing, same type of clientele you get at Airbnb as well. And I was able to do it. We really thought out this place. We added a theme. It's a New York-based theme. I used to live here, and now I wish I lived here the way it looks now. It's definitely not the way I saw it. I used a professional, I used a designer. You guys can just get a lot of tips and tricks from this, or you can find a designer in your area to use. But this is my story, and this is how I was able to double my rent. So guys, I'm gonna show you guys some of the designs I did, and you guys can take it into your repertoire and see if you wanna use any of it. But like, this is a one bedroom apartment. Maybe you have some places like that. This couch does not pull out, but you could do that to add more. You guys can always think to maximize your profit. I'm gonna show you a bit about this space here. We wanted it to look very old, New York City, very art gallery. I really encourage you guys to like relook at your spaces, because this is where we actually had a couch before, and now it's our dining room table. We installed a light here, and that's the beauty of having a designer that designed your Airbnb. And the pictures look phenomenal on the listings, and you get a lot of clicks, and it's all about the click through in order to get the top dollar. So I got a one bedroom, and we ended up getting in a king size bed. It's very important to have a king in your Airbnb, because that'll actually get you a higher rent, if you ask me. And that's what people are looking for. So we were able to do that here. We really designed the room again with the New York feel, and I was able to renovate this up to a four seasoned level. It was only a three seasoned room before. I originally thought it was gonna be more of a porch area, but now it's turned into the bedroom's closet. So they have a giant walk-in closet, and then we pop into the backyard over there, and they can pop out for some drinks or whatever they wanna do while they're here. So you might be wondering, like, what's the cost to do all this stuff? You know, this probably ran me close to $10,000 to do this. And you might be thinking that's insane, but maybe you are in a market where you need to spend $10,000 in order to really attract top clients. And I'm in an area in London, Ontario, where I feel like I need to attract top clients. This is what I did. But here's the bonus, guys. Yes, I spent $10,000 on designing it and getting all the stuff in here. I got a really amazing refinance value and was able to get it all back. So it was relatively, everything you're seeing is relatively for free. It's kind of like that smoke and dagger thing. It shows very well to an appraiser. They're going to appraise it very well because they've never seen a place that looks this good before. So this is a really good strategy for you guys. If you just buy a bunch of stuff off Kijiji, you may not get that best appraisal value. And like I said, you don't know if this is $100 or $25, but it looks really good. And that's what we kind of went for in this Airbnb. And it really, you guys can really double your rent, and you can do it all relatively for free in a refinance as well. So one of the things you want to always have in an Airbnb is some kind of office. It's one of the buttons you can click off that they can have a workspace. Now, that can be everything from a small little desk to this beautiful area that I have here with this artificial grass, which gives them that kind of that Google feel that they're indoor, outdoor kind of like working, because you know, they're hard professionals that are coming over here. They're working every day. They don't get time to go suntan all the time. So they kind of want to be out here in this nice four seasoned area. They can open up a window, but they have the nice view of the street, and we really designed it well so that they can, it's kind of like tranquil in this area here. So I'll show you guys nice simple kitchen. We kept a lot of things the same, but we ended up adding the old charm to a lot of it. And just the simple things you're gonna learn in the checklist, all the Keurigs that you need for Airbnb. I actually kept the fridges and dishwashers that I had before. You know, I try to keep the cost low. Obviously you can see there's money spent in designing, but I kept all the old stuff. When they're coming in, they just need a quick place to cook some food. It's good enough, and we're leaving it for now. One day maybe I upgrade, but I just kept it. So guys, the beauty of being in a duplex and doing this, you don't get one Airbnb, you get two. And now we're upstairs in this other unit here. And it was, again, it was designed with Airbnb and executive renters in mind. So this is what we're doing. I'm gonna show you guys around and what I ended up doing. So one of the things I had to do out here, it was a three-seasoned room, and the ceiling was coming down, water was coming here. We had a bucket of water that it was collecting. I had to get the whole roof fixed, and I was able to turn it into a four-seasons room by getting all new windows and adding, again, the artificial carpet, the grass up here that you get to that feel, that indoor, outdoor. This is my favorite space in the entire house. I love coming out here. It's a great place to read a book, do whatever you need to do, a little bit of exercise, whatever the guest or long-term stayer is going to do, this is the place to do it, and really enjoyed it. What I did was I did two windows that open on either side, so you get a bit of that cross breeze, but every other window I just went with non-opening, and I think I made the right decision because I saved money on each window pretty much, but I wanted to make sure that they could open up the window here and there. So over to here, we ended up designing the room again to that New York style, visit London but stay in New York City. And as you can see here, it's got that workspace that a person can come and use their laptop, which is very important with Airbnb. And I've been getting a lot of great reviews of this place. You know, fingers crossed, it's all been 5 stars so far. So really using my old landlord knowledge to really communicate with the guests. And it's not that hard, guys. It's a couple texts here and there. Hope you have a good stay. These kind of things like that. Let me know if there's any problems. I'll sort it out. And that's about it. That's all there's to it. It's nothing to get too scared about. You just set it up nice and easy for them to stay, and you provide good customer service, and you attract very good clientele, especially when you're attracting top dollar for these places. So when you first start your listings, you may have to start a little bit lower in price, but now as my reviews are going up, I'm able to keep creeping up the cleaning fees and also the amount of the nightly stay, and because you have a lot of good reviews all of a sudden now. So let's check out the rest of the unit. So this is the kitchen. Before, it was just a galley kitchen that we had here. I was able to renovate it, open up a wall right here, and turn it into a nice functioning kitchen with the triangle, and getting them the farmhouse sink that's the last one at IKEA. So people come in, they seem to love the place, and we give them a little bit of a kitchenette here that they can dine in. And I added another bedroom in the back. So we have this bedroom right here. Remember, just like I said, it's very important to have a king size bed in your Airbnb because people want to stay there. They don't always want to just stay in a queen, especially since we're going with luxury. We want to be able to provide those options for them. So this is the extra bedroom that I added. There was a three-seasoned room here. We punched through the brick, added this nice wood around it, and popped into this bedroom that's over here now. We designed it again with a New York flair. We even have a mural on the wall, which really like elongates the space. We're really like thinking outside the box in these places. And I've been getting, again, nothing but compliments in the review system. And the best part is too about this room, you got a bit of area that they can get changed in here, but they have a walk-in closet right over here as well. So It's pretty cool that they have this space here. It sleeps four, so two couples usually, and you can maximize your rent. The more bodies you get into the Airbnb, especially at this high price range, you're making money.
I really appreciate you guys watching this video. Again, if you guys would hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. We will be back on the channel with a lot more, you know, more fun real estate tips coming out to you guys. We will get through this together, us, the community, the world, because that's what we do. We always strive on. We always say, even on this channel, problems are profits, so be successful landlords in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye.